Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I'm very excited to be showing you guys how to do this cool, smooth whip slide transition. I use it in my music videos. I think it's great for creative edits in general. And we're gonna be creating this effect in Adobe Premiere Pro and Adobe After Effects, and I'm gonna show you guys two ways to make this effect. So let's get into it. The first thing you do is you drag this first clip above the second clip, and you're gonna get this timing how you want it. I want this transition to start maybe like as I'm getting close to him during this shot. So I'm just gonna go ahead and extend this clip below it. I'm gonna make a cut right there on the top clip, right? So this is gonna be our whip slide transition layer right here. You see how it's separate from the rest of that clip. Click on this clip, right click it, and hit nest. This is gonna save us any issues we might have with frame rate in Adobe After Effects. And now that it's nested, we're gonna right click on it and hit replace with After Effects composition. That's gonna open it up in After Effects. So the first step we wanna do is just duplicate this layer. So hit Command D on our keyboard. So now with this top layer selected, we're gonna come up here to our Roto Brush tool and double click on the layer. And let me zoom in here by hitting Command Plus. And now we're just gonna trace the outline of the artist. And I'm gonna get rid of some areas by holding Option on my keyboard and clicking in those areas. I'm gonna let go when I see areas that I want it to trace. Depending on how good you trace out your first frame, After Effects will do a great job just kind of tracing the rest of the frames for you. I've got them pretty much traced out here. And I'm just gonna hit 2 on my keyboard, and this is gonna go to the next frame. So I'm just gonna keep hitting 2 and looking for any frames that I might wanna clean up, right? And by saying clean up, I mean looking for any areas that I might have missed or that the computer is missing and going in and tracing over it as we move down the timeline. I'm just gonna keep hitting 2 here until we get to the very end of this clip. We're missing some of his jeans here because it wasn't in the beginning of the shot, so we have to trace that and tell the program that that is something we want traced. All right, so we're here at the last frame. We have a very nice rotoscope going, right? So if I click back into my composition now and I turn off the first layer, we're gonna see that this top layer just has him cut out on a transparent background, right? So this is what we wanna have happen. And go ahead and turn off the top layer for now. So that'll make it a little bit easier to see. Go to Effects and Presets, and we're gonna type in an effect called Offset. Okay, so we're just gonna drag that onto this bottom layer. And from here, we're gonna go to the very first frame where this transition is gonna start. We're gonna make a keyframe on the shift center 2. And then we're gonna come all the way to the last frame, just move our value here to the right a few. So it slides over maybe 4 or 5 times. And what the offset effect is doing is it's just duplicating your layer without actually duplicating it so that you don't end up having to hit Command D and duplicating the same layer a million times. You wouldn't want that. So this is a very easy way to kind of get this effect. So now as I scroll back here, you can see we get the kind of whip motion starting to happen. So what I'm gonna do now is open up my nested sequence right here, and we're gonna go to Effects, Offset. In our keyframe editor, we can see the two values. So we actually want this to start slow and then pick up speed towards the end. Right click on this first keyframe, hit Keyframe Assistant, Easy Ease Out. And then on this last one, we're just gonna leave it as linear. With this first keyframe, we're gonna select it and hit this graph editor icon. And this bar should pop up right here. If you don't see this line popping up, you can just come down here to the choose graph type, make sure you're on edit speed graph, right? So then what I'm gonna do next is just pull this handle out so you can see the line starts to bend, right? So it starts slow and then it gets really fast towards the end, right? So now if I play that back, check it out. So it's a lot smoother than just going from point A to point B. Now we're kind of accelerating to point B, right? So using the graph editor to tweak your keyframes is something I highly recommend when you're doing an effect like this. Now I'm just gonna close out of the graph editor and I'm gonna apply a Gaussian blur. Type in Gaussian blur, drag it onto this layer, and we're gonna keyframe the Gaussian blur, right? For this, since it's going from left to right, I only wanna blur the horizontal pixels. And I'm gonna start the blur right here at 0, right? So I'm gonna make a keyframe for it to not be blurry at all in this beginning. And then as it reaches the end, we want it to be pretty blurry, right? So we're just gonna blur it a bunch here at the end. It's gonna automatically make our keyframe since we've already made a keyframe. And you wanna make sure that you have repeat edge pixels selected, right? So if I turn that off, you can see on the edges, it just fills in the edges. I don't know why it doesn't do that automatically. I don't know why you wouldn't want it to repeat edge pixels, but yeah, it's there. You wanna make sure it's turned on. And now when I play back, check it out, right? So it starts to get blurry as the motion begins. Now I think this looks pretty good. If you want to get more technical with it, you can edit the value of the Gaussian blur keyframes the same way we did the offset keyframe. So we're just going to come down here to easy ease out on this first keyframe, go back to our graph editor, tweak this handle and close the graph editor. And that way it's a little bit more in sync with the offset itself. Now that we have this effect going on, we can turn back our rotoscope layer and you can see now we have like this trippy whip slide effect. So if you want to take this one step further and make it even more trippy, you can take this background layer and change the opacity. So we're just going to change it from 100. We're going to come all the way down to the end here and change it to 0. So it starts as 100 and then it fades away, and then he kind of falls into the background, right? Maybe we just kind of have him slide out of the frame to the right as well, kind of like the transition, right? So we're just gonna make a keyframe on this position, and then we're just gonna drag him out here to the outside, and we're gonna do an easy ease out as well. So right click on that first keyframe, easy ease out. You already know, you know, we're gonna do a little tweaking, make it look nice and cute. And then, so it's kind of like this delayed slide out, right? But he doesn't have motion blur on him. He's not blurring as he's moving. So you want to make sure that you turn motion blur on here in your settings. So it's just got to go through each frame and just kind of render. And you're going to see what it looks like now that it has motion blur on. So see how blurry he gets right there. And that's just going to make the slide look a little more natural. So if I hit play, we get that trippy whip slide effect. I'm going to hit Command S. And we're gonna save it back into Adobe Premiere Pro. All right, so here we go. Dancing in front of the car. Dope car, by the way. And then boom. So now I'm gonna show you guys one more example so you guys get an even better idea of how you can play around with this effect. So we have some other clips from this music video down here at the end of my timeline, him flexing in front of the car, and then we have him walking along the wall. I'm just gonna drag this clip of him walking along the wall underneath this clip of him flexing, and we're gonna make this a pretty quick transition, right? So maybe just the last part of this clip is the transition, maybe just like this much. So we're just gonna cut that top clip right there. We're gonna right click on it, hit nest, hit okay. And now we're gonna bring it into After Effects. All right, so here we got it in After Effects. And what we're gonna do now is again, duplicate this layer, rotoscope him out of the background on this top layer. So again, we're just gonna trace around him and make sure that all the rest of these lines are pretty locked on, right? So it's doing a pretty good job here of guessing what areas I want traced. I'm not having to clean up much here. As you can see here, we're starting to slip into some of that car in the background. So I'm just gonna hold Option, get rid of that stuff in the background. Now I'm gonna click back on my composition. As you can see, we got them cut out. Pretty good, good enough. And then we're just gonna turn on the background layer. Okay, so now we have the background layer. I'm gonna turn my rotoscope layer off. Again, guys, we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna apply an offset effect to this bottom layer. So let's make a keyframe here at the very first frame. We're just gonna leave the values how they are, come to this last frame down here, and we're gonna move it from top to bottom, right? So we're just gonna move this value. So there we are at our last frame. If I play it back, so it's pretty harsh on the eyes, of course. What we're gonna do first is open up our keyframes under our offset, and we're gonna do same thing we did last time. We're gonna do easy ease out, just like that. We're gonna tweak the keyframe value, close the graph. Now we get a more gradual effect. And now what we're gonna do is add the Gaussian blur on top of it. So again, just click and drag the Gaussian blur on top of your layer. And we're gonna keyframe the values for the vertical pixels, okay? Cause we're going up and down now. I'm just gonna make a keyframe here at the very first frame, and I'm gonna scroll to the end. I'm gonna make it really blurry, going up and down. That's pretty trippy right there. And again, we're just gonna open up our Gaussian blur down here under our layer panel. And we're gonna right click on that first keyframe, easy ease out, tweak the graph. Boom, and then make sure that you move these keyframes to the very last frame, okay? So now here's what it's looking like, right? So a lot better on the eyes, a lot more natural. And now what we can do is turn that rotoscope layer back on. So here we go, boom. Pretty trippy, right? Maybe this time we have him kind of shrink down to the bottom of the screen. And so we're just gonna open up that rotoscope layer. We're gonna hit position, hit scale, and then drag your scrubber to the end here. And we're gonna tweak his position and scale. So maybe he just gets really small, and we're gonna move him kind of like down and outside to the right. So as we scroll back, you can see it just kind of like fades away right there, okay? But one more thing, we gotta add motion blur so that the motion looks natural. And then we're also gonna highlight both of those first keyframes and hit easy ease out. And now if I scroll through it, you can see we get that effect, right? So he's just kind of going, gone. And then if I hit save, Command S, hop back here into Premiere Pro, and here we go, right? So it starts out with him, slow motion, flexing in front of the car, and then there goes the background, and then into the next clip, right? I love the smooth whip slide transition videos other people put out there on YouTube. This isn't the only whip slide transition there is. It's just a really cool way I thought of doing it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button down below. And if you're a creative person who wants to be a part of a community of other creatives where we all help each other grow and get better visuals, definitely consider hitting that subscribe button. We're gonna be coming out with a lot more tutorials this year. We're gonna be building this community up, and I'm very excited about a lot of the packs that I'm dropping on my website, ventervisuals.com. I'll include a link for that down below if you're interested in checking it out. I got overlays, transitions, light leaks, and a bunch of other stuff on there, all of which you can try for free. So if that's interesting to you, definitely check out the link below. And until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venter. Peace out.